Personal log. Mission Specialist Kate Ward. Sentient Contact Assessment and Response Team. We always wondered if we're alone in the universe. We observed and explored, but found nothing. Until now.
Call Mission Control to Hermes. Status check.
All systems nominal. We're working on a solution for our scan power requirement. We'll update soon.
Roger that, Hermes. Keep us posted.
It's a giant blue Dorito chip.
Kate, we have an issue.
Problem with the scan?
We've underestimated the power requirements necessary to penetrate the Metahedron's hull. Mike has an idea, but he could use a hand. He's in the lab and he'll give you the details.
On my way.
Comics.
Mike's comic book, Mike's vintage sci-fi comic. He says he fell in love with the old sci-fi themes at a very early age and is proud of his big collection of rare issues. If you ask me, these are surely missing some role models for little girls that once become astronauts. Well, you're one now, so become that one. Ooh. Mike's parents didn't always understand what he was working on or what he was obsessed with, but he could always count on their support and love. Hey, look, it's Starfield over there.
The day when Tam and I graduated and decided to join the space program. Never thought it would lead to alien objects in space.
Students Kate Ward and Tamara Coleman, Yale University.
Tam was lucky that Robinson interrupted us. I was on the verge of victory.
Jarmo, an abstract strategy board game from the Eurasian steppe. Let's just say that one of the grandsons of Genghis Khan played a game of Jarmo before each battle to prepare himself. This particular set was a present from Tam's grandmother. Alright, let's move out.
It has been 6 months since the alien object known as the Metahedron suddenly appeared above Earth's atmosphere. The Hermes mission is currently making preparations to engage with it and attempt contact. Earlier this morning, we managed to snatch an exclusive interview with Richard Robinson, commander of the newly formed SCAR team. Don't miss it. Tonight at 7 on Newsline.
I don't think talking to a floating blue Dorito in space would be a good idea. Sensitivity is a little bit too high. Let me turn that down real quick. Put it down to 5. That's a little bit better. Favorite cup. Tan gave me this cup. She keeps borrowing it, so I mostly see it at her workstation. Kanji lessons. My kids have been teaching me both kanji and katakana. One can never know enough languages.
Hey, Kate. I think I figured out a way to give us the power we need for the scan. I've attached the scanners directly to the engines.
Wow. Directly? Brave.
I think it'll work, but we need to find a way to kickstart the process with around 500,000 volts.
Do we still have those SLD-26 welders in the equipment room?
Yeah, I think we have one or two, but why do you... Oh! You want to modify it to discharge high-voltage electricity. And you call me brave.
Oh, boy.
What the hell is this? The Biobed, advanced nano dot spectra. It's a space bed. SLD-26 welder. Standard space mission equipment. These welders are made specifically for preparing outer layers of modular space stations. Using latest laser technology, they utilize a high energy beam to fuse materials together. They are efficient and easy to use.
Now I need to craft a rail module at the mobile printing unit. There. It should be strong enough to direct and focus the electrical current.
Okay.
To fit all this together.
But do I just drag and drop?
Only missing a power source. I have to adjust the frequency of the Tesla coil first.
Oh, kitty.
I see Mr. Jefferson is in the lab today.
Yeah, I never leave my home planet without him.
Just like Mass Effect.
There. Now just to calibrate the output voltage.
Beep. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it. There we go.
That looks like a space blaster.
Just a tool. Nothing else. It's a vectorized energy rail accelerator, discharging electrical...
Vera! Let's call it Vera for short.
You sure like to name things. Vera it is.
Aloe Vera. Give me my space gun. Ooh. I feel like I should need like a suit or like an electrical suit or something. Because there's no way something's gonna go this smooth.
Mike, I'm in front of the reactor. What's the best way to power it with extra energy?
See the three positronic nodes surrounding the core? A jolt to each one would be sufficient. Yes, keep it up! Almost there. We need a little more energy for the reaction. Huh. Let's try a direct shot to the core. Straight to the heart.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous at all.
You give love a bad name back.
It's working. I'm feeding the excess power directly to the scanner.
I haven't seen you shoot like this since the College Rifle Championship.
Yeah, I also remember you taking first place from me.
And don't you forget it.
Good job. Dr. Ward, Dr. Yoshida, get to the bridge, please. Time to see what's inside our alien guest.
I should return Vera to the equipment room. She served her purpose.
For now. Says another button, see there's a sprint.
Telemetry check.
Telemetry check. We're go.
How are we doing with that sensor array, Mike?
We're ready, Commander.
You have the honors, Dr. Ward. Take your place when ready and start the scan.
What, this? The seat? Over here. Let's go.
Excess energy seems to have done the trick. The array is locked on the Metahedron and operating at almost 200% of its standard efficiency. Say the word, Commander.
Just a moment, Dr. Ward. Team, can I have your attention, please? Since the dawn of humankind, our species has gazed toward the skies and wondered whether we were truly alone. Well, 6 months ago, we got our answer. And with it, came new questions. What is this object in front of us? Where did it come from? Who sent it? And why? While the governments, leaders, thinkers, and common people discussed the meaning of this event, we were training. We were preparing. The SCAR team. Now, the whole world is relying on us. We're dreamers and skeptics. We're explorers and pioneers. With hearts and minds, with courage and resolution, with trust and fellowship. with science. We're going to give the world their answers. And in this historic moment, at the conjunction of hopes and fears, there's no people I'd rather face the unknown with. Dr. Ward, you have the honors. Let's do this.
Let's make the Rito contact.
Scared?
Of course I am.
I thought you army pilots were trained not to be.
We're trained to control it. The fear keeps us sharp. How are you holding up, Doctor?
Oh, I'm 100% sharp, all right.
So, do you think it's a weapon?
Well, a weapon is a very human concept. Perhaps what we perceive as a weapon is just a tool. Wait, the scan. The Metahedron's energy levels are rising rapidly. Okay, what happened?
Power supply failing.
Sensors offline.
I'm switching to backup generators. I'll try to reroute.
Look, the Metahedron, it's creating some sort of a gravity well.
The Hermes is being pulled towards it.
Hang on, everyone. Dr. Ward! Kate!
Whoa.
Commander Robinson? Tam? Mike? Anyone? Where are you? What is this place?
All thanks to the giant Dorito.
What's happening?
Sayadana.
Who was that? Where am I?
Figure that out. Just like a strange range of stamina. Where? I can't see it. Is that like a stamina bar? Or will she start breathing heavy?
Science.
Wait!
A. B. Oh. Okay. Strange plan. The last thing I remember from the Hermes was staring at starting the scan of the Metahedron. There was a blast. Next thing I knew, I woke up alone on a strange planet. I met a strange apparition. It seems to be guiding me. Somehow, I feel I should follow it and uncover what it has to show me. Let's go. Yep, that way. Looking pretty all right. Oh, that's a dodge button. Oh, God, we got Dark Souls buttons now. Okay, I know what's going down. God damn it.
How is this possible? What planet is this? Did the Metahedron bring us here?
It was all this. Oh, what the hell is that thing in the open? Nothing here. Fuck it. Okay, right way. Uh-oh.
Some sort of alien structure.
2001, A Space Odyssey.
Emergency signal. It must be someone from the team. I have to get to them.
What the hell is this? Refill health and limited amounts of ammo, but also respawns enemies. Remove barriers will not appear. Yep. Looks like we're playing a Souls-like with guns.
The debris, it's... it's from the Hermes. It must have splintered off when the ship entered the atmosphere. A Scar field backpack. Empty, but still useful.
Electric cutter. This tool is used for cutting the hardest materials as efficiently as possible. The electric cutter was invented a few years ago and has become an essential part of everyday space missions since...
This electric cutter can cut through even the toughest materials. I'd better take it with me.
Open my inventory and examine. Select the inventory and choose to examine a little more about it. Okay. Oh, I just... okay. Ooh.
Log entry. A joint-legged invertebrate life form, similar to Arachnida. Fast movement, small frame. Seems to move in groups. They're dead.
Carbon-based fiber filaments used for 3D printing can be used as structural components for crafting. Okay, so I only got a scan on new creatures for the first time. Okay. What the hell is with that door? You know, probably can't go that way yet anyways.
Log entry. This plant doesn't have any chloroplasts, which means it can't conduct photosynthesis. Strange.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna be a whole lot of crafting materials in this game, I see. I'm down with that.
Just a bit. We don't want to fry the coil. There. Awesome. We did it, Kate.
I remember this. Mike and I were finishing our electrical experiment just after lunch.
Oh, is that gonna be the Scar? No, Vera. Yes, it is.
Vera, it's still intact.
Yaha. Okay, so I gotta go back. I gotta shoot those things on the door now.
What the hell was that?
Ooh. My toxicity down. Shit. Climb.
Must be a gate of some sort. But there's an obvious locking mechanism.
It is obvious. What are you talking about? Okay, so I want to press Y, do a healing thing. Yeah, figure that. Reloading. Damn, that toxicity. Okay, it doesn't last that long.
Feels like I'm moving through entrails.
Probably are.
Log entry. I found a strange alien cube. It's emitting neural waves. This means it has the potential to send information directly to the brain.
Knowledge cubes gain ability points, all right? Damn it. Fuck. Have anything I can... Yeah, I don't have anything. Shit. Yeah, I don't have anything. Oh! Spend ability points in xenobiology and engineering branches. As Cape progresses on a journey, she'll unlock new personal abilities. I have no points yet. But I thought I said I had one, though.
Log entry. Large joint-legged organism. The chemicals in its abdomen can create an explosion when heated to a certain temperature.
Fuck. Shit. I should probably head back to that thing I saw earlier. Yeah, I'm gonna have to. Damn it. How do I rebuild the healing item? Back travel real quick. God damn it. At least it's not too far, though. She got a lot of stamina. Wait, that was one straight ahead. Screw it. Not taking any chances. Alright, it's called a healing stimulant. That's what it is. Okay. Keep moving forward. Wait, wasn't that like a slogan for a car commercial? Kia, right? Damn it! You're fucking up real bad. Oh, Jesus. I don't have anything to get rid of toxicity. I gotta wait till the very last second. I can't dodge all of them in that shit. Fuck. Died already. Fucking hell. I remember Dark Souls. Attacking takes stamina. stamina back up. Mind you, spider bitch. Come on, get out of it. Come on, come on, come on. Go. Did it kill itself? I guess it's a suicider. Approach pillars to use them as a respawn point in case you die. Interacting with pillars replenishes your health, ammo, power, and stamina and respawns enemies. This has no effect on the amount of resources you can carry.
These cables, they're from the Hermes. Flesh-like webbing. I have to break through it. Log entry. Strong organic tissue, but the blisters appear to be filled with diethylene. Most likely flammable.
I gotta find something to burn them then. Slide on through.
Log entry. This is a bio-vessel for an indigenous creature. The shell seems highly combustible. It contains an organism that is almost fully formed. I better not touch it.
Yeah, there's a whole lot of them. Probably going to burn it down like a xenomorph. Space weed. This complex plant consists of intricate chains of short polypeptides, which suggests enhancing effects of cognitive ability and focus. Highly flammable chemical. Ooh, okay. Thermite projectile. Anything else here?
This equipment, it's from the Hermes, but we were there just an hour ago. Commander Robinson loves this book.
Don Quixote. Okay.
The whole place is covered with some kind of organic residue.
Yeah, let's get up. Hit it. Robinson made some kind of shelter from the equipment of the Hermes. How long was he there? The whole place was covered in strange growth. I have a bad feeling about this. In his log recordings, Robinson didn't sound like himself. He was scared and enraged. What happened to him?
Commander Richard Robinson, log entry. Ever since I left the Hermes, it's been getting worse. The growth. I have to get it off. salvaged some electrical components. I might be able to craft an incendiary device with the MPU. Burn the growth! The body must be cleansed!
Ever since he left the Hermes? But we were just there. He sounds different. Enraged.
Thermic module, crafting weapon. Wait, how long were we out? Jesus.
Maybe. Yes, I can print a custom emitter with the MPU, connect it with the thermic module, and attach it all to the welder's frame.
Okay. Different weapons can trigger certain effects on enemies, such as burn, poison, slow, etc., or help you get through otherwise impassable obstacles. Pay attention to the effect icon and bar on top of the target. The icon changes when the bar is full and the effect is triggered.
This might burn straight through that flesh-like webbing. And I'm taking the MPU.
Good thing you don't share charges, then. Right. Okay. Let's go. Charging can be used to set just close to the top to the fire before they hatch. Fiber. Alright. Alright, cool. Let me just do this to get my ammo back. Alright. Arachnid Scorpod's head. The head was violently ripped from the body. This must have been a vicious battle between two creatures, probably a territorial war. The fact that the Scorpiopod lost its head doesn't necessarily indicate it lost a fight. Something big's here. That. Booty point. Let's go. That's injectionless 50% it's on correctly. When a weapon reclines after 5 seconds. Ooh. Which one do I want? Can I get the Xenobiology? Let's do engineering and Kate's battery for using gadgets. Would that be the Vera? I think so. Okay. down. Clearly can't get through here because that's not active, so I gotta find a way around.
I don't see the energy points on this gate. Perhaps they're on the other side.
What's this? Pile of bones gives me fiber. And I'm not alone in the water.
Mana Tuva. How far would you go in the search for answers?
This way. Ooh, it's over here. Squeeze on through. Give me more brain power. Resistance booster. Remove all negative effects and their buildup. Hold LB to select a consumable when in the lower half of the wheel. The selected consumable is placed in the quick slot and can be used by pressing RB. Every consumable uses a specific amount of fiber. Okay. Yeah, I figured that already. Something's here.
Oh, shit!
Fucking hell. Let's go, baby. Gotta wait for that to die down. Thank you for that. Incendiary extract. Yeah, I can't use any of those. Well, that will last for this. Thank God I let go of that button. Something around this corner. Look at that. Another healing injection.
Log entry. I have cataloged all of the medical supplies for our mission. Potent stuff. Boosters, stimulants, bioenhancers. I know our mission will have plenty of unknowns, but this seems like overkill. Better safe than sorry, I suppose.
Yeah, because I'm going to need all that. How many? No, it doesn't really say. Oh! Okay, that's what I had to use. This place is gonna have a lot of things. Oh, I was making a mistake again. Wait, then what was Y for? Those? Yeah, but it don't do anything. Oh, those are slow healing, I guess, while the Y one is instant. All right, got it. Trying to figure out where everybody's at. Fuck.
How far would you go?
I don't know how far I'm gonna go, but
Robinson's
right now.
Backpack. He was here. I should look around and try to reconstruct his movement. The whole backpack is covered in organic residue.
Can I burn it? Nope.
Robinson must have lost balance and grabbed this rock. Seemed like he had trouble walking. Carnivorous worm-like organisms secreting acidic saliva. It would melt my suit and my flesh in moments.
So it means he might have fell inside there.
Robinson's boot. Apparently he was heading towards the water.
Oh, he went, oh, yep.
He had issues walking, but pushed himself into the worm-infested water. The worms converged on him. They seemed to fuse with his body. What happened to you, Richard? His signal is on the other side. Somehow he got through the worms. I won't last a moment, but I must find a way across.
Yeah, I guess it's whatever he was covered in is what saved him from doing all this. Cryogenic extract, freezing extract of suspended particles of ice can be used as cryogenic ammo. Too bad I don't have that upgrade yet. Good to have. Boss time. I heard a roar.
I can see the energy points on the gate from this side.
Rest and then push onward. Ah, shit. Okay. You guys supposed to use those when enemies are in the water to do like a massive shock. Thank you. More knowledge. I'm really enjoying this game. Really digging it. Head this way. Anything here?
Yep.
Okay. Under the branch. Hitting different body parts will result in increased, decreased damage and sometimes even provoke different enemy behaviors. Some weak points are color-coded and can only be broken with enough damage of a specific type. Electric damage is bright blue, heat damage is orange. Bring it, you big bastard.
That rock armor is too tough. Of these creatures goes beyond typical territorial behavior. Is something causing such hostility?
How would you know? You're not from this planet.
Log entry. This creature is covered with a protective layer consisting of sedimentary rock from the surrounding area. Its exposed heart is filled with highly flammable bodily fluid.
Thank you. Thank you. Ooh, what's that? It's like a door.